Allow me to invite, on behalf of the civil society, Commissioner George Morara. May I request you, as you come up, with all humility, that you kindly restrict it to a minute. Most kindly so. Welcome.
Ken's family, starting with Monica, Ken's mom, Angeline, the Right Honorable Raila Amolo Odinga, all the leaders present, I'm going to read a tribute on behalf of the human rights community of Kenya. Article 73, sub-article 1b of our constitution tells us that the authority assigned to a state officer and a member of parliament, as Ken was, is a state officer, vests in the state officer the responsibility to serve the people rather than the power to rule over them. Tom Ndang'i reinforces what leadership is all about when he says, and I quote, "The secret to success is good leadership. And good leadership is about making the lives of your team members and colleagues better." Everyone who knew Ken and interacted with Honorable Ken surely agrees that he lived up to the true calling of Article 73 of our Constitution. The Ndang'i's quote reflects the type of leader and man he was. We all have different memories of our experience with him, but we can all agree that he taught us the true meaning of servant leadership. Honorable Okoth was a man who truly cared about the people he worked with and worked for, the people of Kibra, the people of Kenya. This is evident through the innumerable causes that he lent his name to, his time to, and his resources to. Within the human rights sector, Honorable Ken Okoth was always willing to lend all of us in this sector an ear, set aside time to meet with us, and importantly, assist us in pursuing our numerous human rights causes with resolute passion and commitment. He was and still is our human rights champion. Mheshimiwa was deeply involved in coming up with various pieces of legislation, for example, prevention of torture, the coroner's law. He was also passionate on land rights, transitional justice, healthcare, and all other human rights issues. As the human rights community, we intend to keep Honorable Ken Okoth's legacy alive and going by memorializing him through an annual award and event focused on exemplary human rights-centered leadership, the details of which we will share at a later date. On behalf of the human rights community, I wish to pass my deepest condolences to Ken's family, friends, and loved ones. We are grateful for the time we got to spend with Ken, and I know that he will always remain a shining light and a beacon of hope on all those who aspire to serve our people with integrity, humility, and commitment. Muhesh, till we meet again, fare thee well. Allow me to invite you tomorrow. The human rights community is having a farewell for the Honorable Ken Okoth at the Freedom Corner. You're all invited. The ceremony will take place from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. at Freedom Corner. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. May I acknowledge the presence of the Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Moses Cheboi. Thank you. And the Wiper Party leader, former Vice President, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. Thank you for joining us. May I now invite to speak on behalf of all the staff and liaison officers.